GD32 microcontroller series from GigaDevice is said to be compatible with the STM series from ST. LCSE.com, one of the largest component distributors in China, sent me a handful of GD32F103 microcontrollers to test and see how good they actually are. Apart from GD32 being capable of running faster and having faster memory, it should be compatible. I'm not going to do speed tests or other things to test the differences, but I'm testing if GD32F103 can be a replacement for the ST's equivalent microcontrollers in my kind of projects. My development environment for the STM32 microcontrollers consists of system workbench for STM32 and STM32CubeMX. For flashing the chip, I'm using a cheap Chinese ST-Link V2 clone. I started by making a couple of designs for custom development parts, but after a while I decided to take the easy way out and desolder a chip from one of these blue pill development parts and replace it with GD32 chip. After having similar ports with STM32 and GD32 microcontrollers, I took one with STM32 chip and started a simple temperature sensor project. I took I2C temperature sensor, SPI LED driver, and 4-digit 7-segment LED display and started coding. For testing the I2C, I wrote this code to request temperature reading from AM2320 sensor. This will get the current temperature reading in Celsius multiplied by 10 and store it in character array. This part of the code sends that text to the computer through USB using virtual serial port. Last part is showing the temperature with the LED display. That happens by writing each digit to register in the LED driver through SPI. SPI underscore write function is my own helper function which handles chip select pin and waiting until SPI peripheral is ready before trying to send the new byte. This simple project tests basic functionality of I2C, SPI, GPIO, and USB in addition to clock and other core components. I have port with GD32F103 on it and I have uploaded exactly the same firmware to it and you know what? It works without any problems. No need to edit anything or tweak settings. This chip looks exactly like the STM32 version when looking through the debugging adapter. Based on this test, I would say this is compatible enough to be a drop-in replacement for the STM32 parts in my projects. But that's not the whole truth. Another YouTuber, Ralph S. Bacon, tested these chips with Arduino IDE. He found out that bootloader that works with STM32 doesn't work with GD32. That indicates there's a functional difference. He got it working by using another bootloader file, but I didn't manage to do so. No matter which bootloader I tried, I couldn't make it work. At least not as reliably as with STM32 chip. My conclusion is, you can most likely treat GD32F103 like it was STM32F103, if you are using ST-Link or another SWD debugger to flash it. It's hard to say if GD32 is better choice for you, it really depends on the current price, availability, and if you will benefit from speed improvements. Anyway, I'm quite impressed how compatible these actually are. You are welcome to share your thoughts about this kind of compatible microcontrollers in the comment section. You know where the like and subscribe buttons are and how they work. Thanks. Bye.